हेलो पीजी स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ सिस्टमैटिक बैक्टीरियोलॉजी फाइलोजेनेटिक अप्रोच। नाउ बिफोर दैट लेट अस क्विकली रिवाइज व्हाट वी सॉ इन द लास्ट लेक्चर। सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी सॉ बर्गीज़ मैनुअल फर्स्ट एडिशन, इट्स 4 वॉल्यूम्स, देन फेनेटिक क्लासिफिकेशन। Okay, I also remember I told you that I'll tell you about the example in the next lecture about Gracilicutes class and oxygenic photobacteria. So the examples are green sulfur bacteria, red and green filamentous phototrophs, purple bacteria, acidobacteria and heliobacteria. Okay. So let's start with phylogenetic approach. What is phylogenetics? Relating to the evolutionary development and diversification of a species or a group of organisms is phylogenetics. Okay. So a phylogeny is often depicted using a phylogenetic tree. So, similarities in characteristics of biochemical structure such as DNA and proteins are used to develop phylogenetic tree based on their inherited shared traits. Understood? It is a very useful tool for taxonomist, as taxonomy led to the study of phylogeny through the framework of dividing organisms into a hierarchy of taxonomic categories, such as family, genus, species. Fine. Also, in the last lecture, we saw cladistic approach. I hope you remember, where we learned that cladogram, it shows how species may be related by a descent from a common ancestor. So here in phylogenetic classification, it involves placement of organisms in clade. Clade means groups, with their common ancestor. Fine. Now let us begin with phylogenetic classification. Now prokaryotes, its taxonomy is possible with the aid of newer molecular techniques such as the sequencing of ribosomal RNA, DNA and proteins. These techniques has made phylogenetic analysis more practicable. Okay, so in this availability of knowledge of phylogenetic relationships amongst prokaryotes, the second edition of Burgess' Manual of Systematic Bacteriology is largely of phylogenetic rather than phenetics. Understood? So as a result, the second edition is different than the first edition. Okay. Now in this second edition, there are 5 volumes published respectively in 2001, 2005 and so on. Now let us see these 5 volumes in a concise approach. Okay. Volume 1, the archaea and the deeply branching and phototrophic bacteria. Domain archaea, phylum A1, Crenarchaeota. This phylum, it consists of thermophilic and hyperthermophilic sulfur metabolizing prokaryotes, which are arranged in a single class. They are divided into 3 orders and 5 families. Important genera are Thermoproteus, Desulgurococcus, Pyrodictium and Sulfolobus. Fine. Let's see phylum A2. Eurycota. The phylum consists of primarily methanogens and halophiles. They are thermophilic and sulfur reducers. Okay. दे आर डिवाइडेड इंटू सेवन क्लासेस, मिथेनोबैक्टीरिया, मिथेनोकोकाई, हेलोबैक्टीरिया, थर्मोप्लाज्मेटा, थर्मोकोकाई, आर्कियोग्लोबी एंड मिथेनोपायरी. 9 ऑर्डर्स, 16 फैमिलीज. लेट्स सी टोमेन बैक्टीरिया. फाइलम B1, एक्विफेसी. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ वन क्लास दैट कंटेन्स ऑटोट्रॉफिक बैक्टीरिया पजेसिंग एबिलिटी टू यूज हाइड्रोजन फॉर एनर्जी प्रोडक्शन. एक्विफेक्स एंड हाइड्रोजनोबैक्टर आर द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव जेनेरा. एक्विफेक्स मीन्स वाटर मेकर, एज दिस जीनस रिड्यूसेस ऑक्सीजन बाई यूजिंग हाइड्रोजन एंड प्रोड्यूसेस वाटर. लेट्स सी फाइलम B2. थर्मोटोगी. द फाइलम थर्मोटोगी कंसिस्ट ऑफ वन क्लास विच कंटेन्स एनरोबिक थर्मोफिलिक फर्मेंटेटिव ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया. रिप्रेजेंटेटिव जेनेरा आर थर्मोटोगा, जियोटोगा, फर्विडोबैक्टीरियम. फाइन. लेट्स सी फाइलम B3. थर्मोडी सल्फोबैक्टीरियम. दिस फाइलम कंटेन्स वन क्लास एंड टू जेनेरा. थर्मोडी सल्फोबैक्टीरियम एंड थर्मोडी सल्फेटेटर. बैक्टीरिया आर एनरोबिक थर्मोफिलिक एंड सल्फेट रिड्यूसिंग. फाइलम B4. डेनोकोकस थर्मस. दिस फाइलम कंटेन्स वन क्लास. रिप्रेजेंटेटिव जेनेरा आर डेनोकोकस थर्मस, मैरिनी थर्मस एक्सेट्रा. फाइन. दीज बैक्टीरिया आर ग्राम पॉजिटिव. दे आर एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी रेडिएशन रेजिस्टेंट. ओके. लेट्स सी फाइलम 6. क्लोरोफ्लेक्सी. दिस फाइलम कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू क्लासेस, क्लोरोफ्लेक्सी एंड एनरुली. मैनी मेंबर्स ऑफ दिस फाइलम आर ग्राम निगेटिव एंड दे आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ग्रीन नॉन सल्फर बैक्टीरिया. इम्पॉर्टेंट जेनेरा आर क्लोरोफ्लेक्सस, ऑसिलोक्लोरिस, हर्पेटोस्फायोन एंड एनेरोलिनिया. लेट्स सी फाइलम B7. थर्मोमाइक्रोबिया. नाउ इन दिस फाइलम इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ वन क्लास एंड इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय अ सिंगल जीनस थर्मोमाइक्रोबियम. इट इज एन एरोबिक थर्मोफिलिक कीमोट्रॉफ पजेसिंग अनयूजुअल लिपिड्स दैट कंटेन्स 1-2 डायल्कोहल्स इंस्टेड ऑफ ग्लिसरॉल एंड हैव नीदर ईस्टर और इथर लिंकेजेस. आई होप यू रिमेंबर दिस लिंकेजेस. Also, the cells of thermomicrobium, they differ from those of bacteria in that they lack peptidoglycan in their cell walls. Okay. Let's see phylum B8, Nitrospira. This phylum, it consists of one class and genera like Nitrospira and Leptospirillium. Fine. Phylum B9. Deferibacterias. It consists of one class and genera such as Deferibacter and Dinitrovibrio. Okay. Phylum B10, Cyanobacteria. Now this phylum consists of a single class and which is divided into 5 subsections. The taxonomic position of Cyanobacteria is left open in Bogie's manual. They are oxygenic phototrophs and show a distant relationship to gram-positive bacteria. Okay, these organisms were the first oxygen-evolving phototrophs on Earth and were responsible for the conversion of the anoxygenic atmosphere of a planet to oxygenic. ओके, जेनेरा बिलोंगिंग टू दिस फाइलम आर मेंशन्ड एज फॉर्म जेनस बिकॉज दे लेटर रिफर टू अ ग्रुप ऑफ साइनोबैक्टीरिया विथ वेरी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक मॉर्फोलॉजी फाउंड वर्ल्ड वाइड. ओके, नाउ नाउ द इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर्म जेनेराज आर माइक्रोसिस्टिस, साइनोसाइटिस, लिंग्बिया, ऑसिला टोरिया, स्पिरोलिना, एनाबिना, नोस्टॉक, स्काइटोनिमा, कैलोथ्रिक्स, टॉलीपोथ्रिक्स. ओके, फाइलम B11, क्लोरोबी. क्लोरोबिया द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव जेनेरा आर क्लोरोबियम, पेलोडिक्टॉन, क्लोरोबैक्लम एक्सेट्रा. फाइन, दीज आर एनऑक्सीजेनिक फोटोसिंथेटिक बैक्टीरिया नोन एज ग्रीन सल्फो बैक्टीरिया विच कैन एसिमिलेट CO2 थ्रू द रिडक्टिव और द रिवर्स ट्राइकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड साइकिल. ओके, रादर देन द केल्विन साइकिल. एंड दे ऑक्सीडाइज सल्फाइड टू सल्फर ग्रैन्यूल्स दैट अक्यूमुलेट आउटसाइड द सेल. ओके, सो दिस वॉज वॉल्यूम 1. नाउ लेट्स सी वॉल्यूम 2, द प्रोटियोबैक्टीरिया. फाइलम B12, प्रोटियोबैक्टीरिया consist of 5 classes: alpha proteobacteria, beta proteobacteria, gamma proteobacteria, delta proteobacteria and epsilon proteobacteria. Now as we see that proteobacteria, it contains over 400 genera which are all gram negative. They show extreme metabolic diversity and represent the majority of bacteria of pharmaceutical, industrial, agricultural and biological research significance. Fine. It is believed by many that proteobacteria evolved from a photosynthetic ancestor. And presumably, many strains, they lost photosynthetic activity during adaptation to new ecological niches. Okay, alpha proteobacteria, it consists of most bacteria that are capable of growing at low nutrient levels. Okay, for example, oligotrophic forms. Representative genera of this class are Rhodospirillum, Azospirillum, Rickettsia, Rhizobium, Agrobacterium and Nitrobacter. Okay. Now, beta proteobacteria, they utilize the substance that diffuse from organic decompositions in the anaerobic zone of their habitats. Now, some of these genera are pathogenic. So, the important genera included in beta bacteria, proteobacteria are Thermothrix, Bordetella, Lepthothrix, Neisseria, Aquaspirillum, Nitrosomonas, Gallionella, Spirillum, etc. Let's see gamma proteobacteria. They are chemoorganotrophic, facultative anaerobic, and their representative genera are Chromatium, Xanthomonas, Bagiatua, Pseudomonas, Vibrio, Escherichiae, Photobacterium, Klebsiella, Erwinia, etc. Fine. I know this is lot of confusing, but you have to remember is the way it is. Okay. Now, Delta proteobacteria. They can be mainly categorized as 3 groups: Now, many of the delta proteobacteria are anaerobic and they cause desulfurication. Means what? Generate sulfide from sulfate and sulfur. Now, representative genera of such bacteria are desulfovibrio, desulfuromonas, desulfobacca. Some delta proteobacteria, for example, Bacteriovorax are predators on other bacteria. Okay. Representatives such as Myxococcus, Polyangium, Chondromyces are the delta proteobacteria that form fruiting bodies and also prey on other bacteria. Okay. Let's see epsilon proteobacteria, small class and its members like Helicobacter and Campylobacter are important human pathogens which causes intestinal infections. Understood? Now let's go ahead to volume 3, the low G plus C gram positive bacteria. Phylum B13, Firmicutes. I hope you remember. Phylum Firmicutes consists of gram-positive bacteria with low G plus C content. Okay. Molecular percentage value is below 50% in their DNA. Okay. Now, most of the bacteria of this phylum are heterotrophic. Though mycoplasmas lack cell wall and stain gram-negative, they are classified under this phylum because of their close relationship to low G plus C gram-positive bacteria. Okay? The phylum is classified into three classes, Clostridia, Molecutes and Bacilli. Now, class Clostridia, they contains a very wide variety of gram-positive bacteria that vary in morphology and size, but they tend to be anaerobic. Some produce endospores, but others do not. The important genera are Clostridium, Acetobacterium, Desulfoctamaculum, Eubacterium, Heliobacterium, Syntrophomonas. Okay. Now, class Molecutes consist of members that are wall-less and are generally called mycoplasmas. These bacteria are pleomorphic in shape, normally non-motile. They stain negative due to absence of cell wall and they require sterols for growth. Important genera are Mycoplasma, Phytoplasma, Spiroplasma, which contains several important animal and plant pathogens. Fine. Class Bacilli. It comprises of variety of bacteria which are aerobic or facultatively anaerobic cocci and rods. And many of them are endospore forming. Example, Bacillus, Sporosarcinia. Okay. Many genera of this phylum are pharmaceutical and industrially significant. For example, Bacillus, Lactobacillus, Enterococcus. I hope you remember all these names. Okay. Let's see volume 4. The high G plus C gram-positive bacteria. Phylum B14. Actinobacteria. The phylum Actinobacteria is classified into a single class Actinobacteria, which contains high G plus C gram-positive bacteria with molecular percent value more than 55%. Okay. This bacteria shows enormous morphological variation ranging from cocci to regular or irregular rods to extensively branching hyphae. Endospore formation lacks, but many genera do not form a variety of asexual spores. Understood? Now this phylum, it consists of 5 subclasses, 6 orders, 14 suborders. and 44 families and many a member of genera. Now the important genera of Acinetobacter, Actinobacter, I'm so sorry, Actinobacteria are Actinomyces, Arthrobacter, Bravibacterium, Cellulomonas, Clavibacter, Cornibacterium, Mycobacterium, Nocardia, Actinoplanes, Propionibacterium, Streptomyces, Francia. Fine? The largest and the most complex genus is Streptomyces. Over 500 species. Now you can understand how the number is increasing, how the classification is increasing. Okay? Let's go ahead to volume 5. The Plantomycetes, Spirochetes, Fibrobacters, Bacteriodids, and Fusobacteria. Phylum 15. Planktomycetes. This phylum consists of a single class containing four genera named Planktomyces, Chemata, Pyrilula, and Isospira. Members, they lack peptidoglycan and their cell walls are of an S-layer type consisting of proteins. They divide by building and may produce non-prostaticate appendages called as stalks. Understood? Now, let's go to phylum B16. Chlamydias. Now, this phylum consists of a single class and seven genera. Now, this genus is most important genus. Its species cause many human diseases. Okay. Let's see phylum B17, Spirochetes. Phylum is classified into one class containing 13 genera. It is important one as Spirochetes, Borrelia, Treponema, Cristispira, Leptospira. They are gram-negative, motile, helically shaped bacteria which are characterized by unique motility behavior. Okay. Let's see phylum B18. Fibrobacteris represent single class and single genus. Fibrobacter is a cellulolytic gram-negative bacterium occurring in the rumen of ruminant animals where it breaks down cellulose. Okay, I hope you understand ruminant animals. Phylum B19, Acidobacteria. The phylum, it contains one class which is represented by three genera named Acidobacterium, Geothrix, and Holophaga. Okay. Phylum B20, Bacteriodetes. This phylum is divided into three classes: Bacteroids, Flavobacteria, Sphingobacteria. And genera like Bacteroids, Flavobacterium, Flexibacter, Cytophaga, or Toxothrix. Okay. Flexibacter and Cytophaga, they are the gliding bacteria and are ecologically significant. Fine. Let's see phylum 21. Fusobacteria. This phylum, it contains one class with genera like Fusobacterium, Leptotrichia, and Cetobacterium. It is filamentous and they occur in oral cavity of humans. Fine. Let's go ahead to phylum B22. हाँ, वेरियोको माइक्रोबिया दिस फाइलम इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ सिंगल क्लास एंड जेनरा सच एज व्यूरोको माइक्रोबियम प्रोस्टेटोकोबैक्टर सिफिने मैटोबैक्टर. नाउ मेंबर्स फॉर्म साइटोप्लाज्मिक अपेंडेजेस कॉल्ड एज प्रोस्थेटिक एंड डिवाइड सिमेट्रिकली. अंडरस्टूड? द लास्ट फाइलम B23 डिक्टायोग्लूमस. दिस फाइलम रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय अ सिंगल क्लास एंड कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ सिंगल जीनस नेम्ड डिक्टियोगोमस. ओके, नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स टू आस्क मी. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस क्लासिफिकेशन, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. ओके, एवरी क्लासिफिकेशन हैज़ इट्स ओन इम्पॉर्टेंस. ओके, स्टार्ट रीडिंग once the syllabus goes forward. You will have a lot of things to remember. Start writing, start making few notes, start studying. Thank you.